one of the things that needs to be understood when we talk about the pastoral challenges for Oceania is that the countries are very different. It's an enormous expanse of the world's area. A lot of it, of course, for the Pacific Islands is just little islands in the middle of the ocean. But it consists of four bishops' conferences: Australia, New Zealand, Papua New Guinea, Solomons, and the Pacific Islands. So the problems in New Zealand and Australia tend to be more of the Western world kind of problems, while in the Pacific Islands and Papua New Guinea and the Solomon Islands, they're not as developed. They often rely on aid. And so I guess the family problems, though, are the same everywhere, in the sense that there are lots of people living together before marriage. There are lots of marriage breakups in all of those societies. But it tends to be slightly different in the Pacific Islands and Papua New Guinea Solomons. A lot of the families there migrate to Australia or New Zealand, particularly Pacific Islands, so that they can get work, which means that families are often leaving young children behind to be brought up by elderly parents or aunts or uncles. So that's a big problem. People struggling to make ends meet financially. In terms of the church and the catechesis about marriage and family, it's probably the same challenge everywhere, trying to help young people to understand what marriage is and that the commitment is a lifelong commitment and that it is based on the sacramental nature of obviously of marriage, and understanding that it's to reflect the love of God. Many of our young people just don't grasp that.